So it's a beautiful day out, and it's a good day to play with water, so that's what we're doing. And basically we're here to test two new small additions to the dynamic pressure regulation system. So we've been using this for a long time for static tests, but one of the new features is that historically what our DPR system has been controlling is pressure in the fuel tanks. But strictly speaking, engine performance does not depend on the pressure in the fuel tanks. It depends on the pressures of fuels at the injector. So for static testing, this is not a big deal because the difference in pressures is rather small and it's constant. But during flight, the difference can be bigger, basically because there's a column of fuel from the tank and down to the engine. And the hydrostatic pressure in that column will then depend on the acceleration of the rocket. So that's a new thing that happens in flight compared to static tests. And it means that it would then be too crude to operate the dynamic pressure regulation on based on tank pressure only. So what we need to do now is to make a switch, because when the main valves for the engines are for the engine are closed initially, there is no injector pressure to control. So we first pressurize the tanks based on the on the tank pressure like we used to, but then as the main valve opens, we switch to instead control the inlet fuel pressures in the engine. And that switch of sensor by which we control pressure is now implemented in software, and we are basically here to see how that works. And then there is one other thing. We usually, so far we've had like a small drop in pressure right when the main valve opens and the pressurization system suddenly needs to pump in a lot of air to maintain pressure. And this drop was like a few bars, and it's basically a result of the control algorithm being rather crude. So the control algorithm itself has also been refined to better handle this initial step by what technically is known as a feed-forward correction. So these are the two things we are here to test today, and we'll do that simply by putting water in the fuel tank and pushing it out with compressed atmospheric air. So stand by for the splash. So we just had the first test, and basically we just saw it running, and I guess the exact term is that it's too early to say that it did not work. So what happens now is I take a closer look at the telemetry data, and then we can see, we can verify that everything worked as intended. So this is it for today. We have had a good test, and the test data showed that the switchover from tank pressure regulation to injector pressure regulation worked as intended. Also, we repeated the test to run it twice to experiment with different parameters for the control system, and that gives us the basis to look at the differences and decide what parameters we would want to use for the Nexø rocket. When this system gets implemented into the rocket, there's actually a few differences from the test today, so we will have to correct for mainly two things. One is that when the engine actually ignites, then the chamber pressure will exert a back pressure on the injector, so for the same injection pressure, the flow will be a lot lower during actual flight than it is here today with no back pressure on the engine. This is a thing we'll have to adjust the control system for, but we have plenty of data to do that because we've had these many static tests on this engine. Another small correction that needs to be made is that today, for convenience, we have done the pressurization with free and available atmospheric air, but that would not work particularly with LOX in the rocket at cryogenic temperatures. So the rocket will instead do its pressurization with helium gas. And helium flows and expands differently from air, so that's the second thing we will have to correct when integrating this system into the rocket. So once the code for the new code for the DPR system is integrated into the rocket, the next test step for it will be to perform during the cold flow test of the assembled rocket with cryogenic fuels and with helium.